हेलो, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ आवर सब्जेक्ट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस इज टास्क इन्वायरमेंट्स। सो वी मस्ट थिंक अबाउट द टास्क इन्वायरमेंट्स विच आर इसेंशियली द प्रॉब्लम्स टू विच रैशनल एजेंट्स आर द सॉल्यूशन। सो व्हाट इज मीन बाय टास्क इन्वायरमेंट? टास्क इन्वायरमेंट इज नथिंग बट द इन्वायरमेंट्स वेयर द एजेंट इज एक्चुअली परफॉर्मिंग द टास्क। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर I have taken the example of the robot which is playing football in a garden. So garden is a task environment for that particular agent or robot. So how we specify the task environment? So we specify the task environment basis on the performance measure, then the environment, that is actual environment, the agents, actuators and sensor. Okay, so these all parameters consist together to form a concept which is PEAS, that is performance, environment, actuators and sensor. In designing an agent, the first step must always be to specify the task environment as fully as possible. That means the task environment should be fully observable, or we can say that it is a fully definable, so that the agent can perform the task into that particular environment. The following table shows the PS description. So let's see the table. So these are the agent types, that means various agents performing task, and these are our PEAS, that is performance measure, environment, actuators and sensor. So let's take the first example, that is first agent type, medical diagnosis system. The performance measure for this medical diagnosis system is healthy patient, minimize cost and lawsuits. Okay, environment is patient, hospital, staff. Actuators may be displayed, questions, test, diagnosis, treatments. Okay, sensors are keyboard entry, op symptoms, findings, patient's answer. Okay, so like these, there are different agent types along with their PEAS. So next one is properties of task environment. So we already saw what is mean by task environment. So what are the properties of this task environment? There are six properties of this task environment. First is fully observable versus partially observable. Next, deterministic versus stochastic, episodic versus sequential, static versus dynamic, discrete versus continuous, single agent versus multi-agent. So let's see one by one. Fully observable versus partially observable. So what is mean by an environment is fully observable or partially observable? If an agent sensor give it access to the complete state of environment at each point in a time, then we say that the task environment is fully observable. That means the agents consider an agent which is consist of sensors, and that sensor is giving access to all the state of environment, to all the states, whatever the states are present in the environment, it is giving access to all the states, then it is said as a fully observable environment. Otherwise, we can treat it as a partially observable environment. An environment might be partially observable because of noisy and inaccurate sensors, or because parts of the state are simply missing from the sensor data. Okay. For example, let's consider an agent which is measuring a temperature in a rainy area. Okay. So, because of some moisture or humidity, it is treated as the partially observable environment. Next one is deterministic versus stochastic. If the next state of the environment is completely determined by the current state and the action executed by the agent, then we can say that environment is deterministic. Okay, so what is deterministic? The next state, that is next state of that particular agent, is next state of the environment is completely determined by the current state. Okay, current state and the action executed then it is a deterministic environment. Otherwise, we can say it as the stochastic environment. Next is episodic versus sequential. Episodic means the tasks are divided into the episode. Okay, whatever the task performed by the agent are divided into atomic episodes. Okay, each episode consists of the agent perceiving and then performing a single action. Okay, so for example, an agent that has to spot defective parts on an assembly line's basis each decision on the current part regardless of the previous decision. So here is the important point that the agent can't determine the next action depend on the previous action, okay, or next episode does not depend on the previous actions or the actions which are taken in the previous episode. So next action is different and the previous action is different. In a sequential environment, on the other hand, the current decision could affect all the future decision. That means the current decision is a final decision. For example, in the game chess and in taxi driving, if we are playing the chess, we take particular movement, then it would affect the future decisions also. And in case of taxi driving, if we are traveling, for example, say 12 kilometers, then taking appropriate turn is important. Or we can also say that if we take the wrong turn, then it would might affect the traveling, or it would might take the high time, or it would might take the large time to reach the distance. Next is discrete versus continuous environment. The discrete continuous distinction can be applied to the state of environment, to the way time is handled, and to percepts and action of the agent. For example, a discrete state environment such as chess game has a finite number of distinct states. That means discrete means what? Discrete means different. Okay, chess also has a discrete set of percepts and actions. Taxi driving is a continuous state and continuous time problem. The speed and location of the taxi and of the other vehicles sweep through a range of continuous values and do so smoothly over the time. Taxi driving actions are also continuous. That means in a case of discrete environment, it is a time bounded process, and in the case of continuous environment, the actions are applied continuously. Next is single agent versus multi agent environment. An agent solving a crossword puzzle by itself is clearly a single agent environment. Or just now in our previous lecture, we saw the example of the vacuum cleaner world, which is also example of what? Single agent environment. And multi agent means what? There are more than one agent are involving, where the agent playing a chess is a two agent environment. One or more agent where requires it is treated as what? Multi agent environment.